Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This video is going to be about the Valcronic exhaust for a car. So I wanted to get the Valcronic setup done for my car, and I didn't want it to be very expensive. So I wanted it to be reliable as well as value for money. In the market you get electric Valcronic exhaust, vacuum based Valcronic exhaust, and there is also a manual Valcronic exhaust, which I'll be talking about in this video. So you know, the electric Valcronic exhaust, most of the time there might be issues with the electric valve, in case the electric valve is placed below, and if it catches water, there are chances that it gets damaged easily, and also you don't get much of a warranty on that, and you also know that it becomes very expensive and it's not worth the price, is what I feel. So same goes with the vacuum. Again, they are also mechanical. It has got a compressor which will be used in a vacuum exhaust, but everything in the market right now demands the higher price. So I wanted to get something done within a budget. So what I did was, I got a custom made Valcronic exhaust for my car. So before that, I would like to say you need to have a full system header installed on your car before going with this procedure, so that you get a proper sound. This is my 1.5 EXI, Honda City 1.5 EXI. So what I've got in this car is headers which has been done by Raj. So people in Bangalore would be knowing about Raj headers. So I have a headers installed from Raj. Just let me show you. Okay, so you could see there are headers installed, and if you come back, what you can see here is the stock exhaust pipe. So this is the stock exhaust pipe, so which will keep the car silent. So it'll, for the city rides and everything where you don't want to be loud, it'll be very silent, but the performance would be there since it has got a full system header. So now with this setup, I have got a custom made muffler. I've got a custom made muffler which has been branched out from the end pipe, so that I want it to be it at the end, because most of them would install this Valcronic at the mid section of the car, which is not recommended, because there might be some amount of backfire to the engine, which will result over the period it will result in the damage of the engine head. So I didn't want to get the car's engine head damaged, so I got it installed at the I got it branched out from the end pipe. So what you can see here is the custom made Valcronic system. You can see there, I will zoom in a bit. Okay, so you can see that is the Valcronic exhaust. So that has been made out of the throttle body. That Valcronic has been made out of the throttle body of the car. So I've used the throttle body of the car to make this Valcronic. Okay, so you could see that. So I got a adapter clamp done, and then branched it out, and then got a custom made muffler for the bass
got a custom-made muffler for the bass so that you get that sweet note rather than that treble sound which you get usually with the open end pipes. So it sounds sweet. I'll put a small clip at the end of this video. Use the headphone so you get a better sound clarity. Okay, so how does this operate? Let me just show you. So it operates with this. I've got a custom on and off clamp done. This is a manual system where you need to pull the trigger for the exhaust to turn on. So you could see I've used the boot opener cable. So that is a long cable which can run from back to the front. So to turn it on, you need to pull this. And leave it. So now the valve is open. And to close it, we need to release this. So the valve is closed. The advantage of this is, like, there are less chances of this getting damaged, and it is much cheaper, believe me, when compared to the Valtronic exhausts available in the market right now. And maximum the cable can snap out, and it is an easily fixable thing where you can buy another cable for 300 or 400 bucks and replace it. It's just like replacing your throttle cable when it snaps out, and it's not going to snap out easily. So, and it's a manual thing, so that's the only drawback of it, that you need to pull it manually. Apart from that, everything is a plus point in this. So this is the setup I have, and we'll be seeing a short video of how it sounds with this setup. So the prerequisite is you need to have a full system headers done. You don't have to install the end can. You can keep your stock end can with that setup so that your car is silent in the city or wherever you want it to be, and then branch it out with a bass can. Depending on the space, how much you have behind, you can design the end can as you want. So I made the custom made end can with a 10 inch length, so it is, which is properly concealed, and it's got a good sweet note. So let me show the routing part. So what I've got it done here is, I think it's too sunny. So you could see there I got a small hole done so that the cable can be routed inside the boot, and from the boot I routed through the boot line so it reaches to the driver side. So I will be putting an anti-rust coat there, and then a metal paste to cover that extra hole so there is no water leakage inside. Another advantage of using the throttle body of the car is that those throttle bodies will be of very high quality, and they don't give up easily. The spring tensions and everything are tested, and they last for a long time, unlike the custom made throttle bodies or custom made valves. You know, I'm not sure what kind of tension they use and how it works, but these throttle body definitely work. To be precise, they cost only, this particular setup cost only about 15% of the Valtronic end can, just the Valtronic end can, 15%. So with the cost of the Valtronic end can, with less than the cost of the Valtronic end can, you can get this complete setup done. So I guess the Valtronic end can right now in the market is costing you somewhere around 26k to 30k, okay, but with just the Valtronic, if you want, it will cost you somewhere from 10 to 15k. So this is much cheaper than that, and I think much reliable. So put on your earphones and listen to the
sound clip which I'll be putting in this video. So hope this was helpful. For any assistance, you can message, and I will leave the contact information of getting this done in the description, so you can go through the description for the contact information. So this is done in Bangalore, so anyone in Bangalore can, you know, utilize this thing rather than spending loads of money on the Valchronic exhaust, which I feel is not worth. So with this note, I will be ending this video. Enjoy the short clip of the Valchronic sound, manual Valchronic sound. Right, see you in another video. Bye.